He calls himself Legend, and he exploded onto the music scene in 2009 when he won the Best Male Rap Artist at the Youth Gospel Entertainment Awards. His real name is Nigel Anderson. Growing up, he was always in church, but his home life was far from peaceful.
My father was an alcoholic. He ended up getting addicted to drugs and, some hard stuff. And, my mother would shelter me from it, so I was never really exposed to those things. But he would come home drunk, come home high, and, she was getting emotionally abused because of that, not physically, but emotionally. And, she would go to rehab. She was trying to work her hardest to save her marriage.
But despite his mother's best efforts, nothing changed, and she decided to leave.
She didn't want to hold on to that relationship at the risk of endangering my life.
Over the next 15 years, Nigel rarely saw his father. And each passing year, the anger and bitterness within him grew.
Most people that know me would say I was just, good guy, good reputation, kind of chill. But on the inside, I was dying, man. I was hurting.
Sometimes it's like the weight of the world's on my shoulders, when it's really the weight of me fighting this world, plus a couple of boulders.
He started partying and sleeping around to deal with his pain.
I just got to a point where I just decided, I was so hurt by Dad not caring, or not caring enough to be truthful with me. I was like, whatever, man. I'm just going to do what I want to do.
Then he began to make music.
I began to make beats. I found out I was good at making beats. I found out I was good at writing rhymes. I just began to dive wholeheartedly into music, and just rapping about any and everything.
Nigel wanted to make a good life for himself and his family. Getting a job at a finance company provided him the opportunity.
I was brought under the wing of a very prominent person in the company, and it was like one of those quick rises to fame. Wow, okay, this is what I've been waiting for. Like, I'm the man.
When his boss got caught defrauding the company, Nigel went down with him. He was out of a job and let down by a role model once again.
At the end of the day, when you opened up your eyes and you saw that you were manipulated into just building up somebody else's pockets, you began to realize that, wow, I've been lied to again.
Shortly after, he received a letter from his father inviting him to lunch.
I didn't know what I was going to do, but I know at the end result of whatever I did, I wanted to cause him some pain back. I wanted him to feel what I've been feeling for 15 years. I wanted him to suffer some. And I remember walking up behind him. At first it was like tears in my eyes, like, wow, what'd I do? I didn't know what I was thinking. Then it turned to anger, and I was like, all right, this is my payback time. I was like, all right, when I walk with this dude, I'm just going to punch him in the face. I touched him and he turned around, and I saw a man in his 50s. It looked like he was 80. He just said he was sorry. All that anger just turned to pity immediately. I said, Dad, hey, I forgive you. And the beautiful thing about that moment was, that was the first time that I think I've ever felt somebody else experience freedom.
A few months later, his dad passed away. Nigel began to ponder what happens after death. He began to seek God for answers.
Decided that I needed to know who this God was. I just cried out to him and I told him that I need you. And if you're really there, I need you to talk to me.
Nigel surrendered his life to God, and opportunities for music began to open up.
Just doors open. I mean, the Lord connected me with people. I met people. I met great people. Still got great relationships to this day. I get to see God do for somebody else what he did for me.
Today, Nigel is married. And he and his wife are expecting their first child.
Without having a natural father, I know that I'm going to be a good father to my child because God's been a good father to me. He gives us everything we need, and then he tosses in bonuses and wants and stuff that we don't even deserve just to kind of wink at us and say, I love you.